Hello children, I'm back and today we are going to start with the next part of the same topic, alphabetical order. Okay, we have three tasks to do, children. First, we are going to see how to use a dictionary. Second, we are going to do a fun activity. And third, I'll be explaining you how to do the worksheet. Okay, the worksheet is also sent in the group. So we are going to go accordingly. Let's start with the dictionary. I have my mind right here. I have an Oxford dictionary. I've covered it. Okay. Now, there are certain parts of the dictionary which I'm going to show you, the important ones right now. Let's begin. Now, what is a dictionary, children? If you could say it in your mind, wonderful. Dictionary is a book which contains words and their meanings in alphabetical order. So all the words along with their meanings, they are placed in a book together in alphabetical order, and that book is called a dictionary. Okay, now I'll show you something in my dictionary, and I'm going to also explain to you. Please pay attention. First thing, dictionary has most of the words. Okay, according to it is like all the basic words are there in the dictionary. Okay, sometimes we have a kids only dictionary, so there certain words are missing. Now you might have a different dictionary at your homes. I have a separate one maybe, or maybe we have the same one. It's okay. You just understand the concept later on when you have your time off, or when you are doing your homework and all, then you can refer to your dictionary. Let's begin, right? I'll show you certain parts. Every dictionary will have something like this. A page number and two words written. Okay, page number shows the words on that page. These two words are called guide words. What are they called? Guide words. Okay, now I've written something already in my sheet here. I'm going to show you. In my dictionary, page number 231, I have handbag and happen as the guide words. Okay, in my dictionary, page 231, I'm going to open it and we'll discuss it further. So it is page. Okay, I have it here. I hope you can see. If not, you mainly need to understand. So I have handbag here and happen here. Now handbag is the first word on this page and happen is the last word on this page. Okay, so both the words are on top. But when you refer them in the dictionary, you will find the first word beginning handbag and the last word is happen according to this page. Now, if you just roughly see handbag and happen alphabetically, obviously they have many other words in between and then happen. Okay. Now, I'm going to give you three words. Tell me if you can understand that where these words will be present. Are they on this page or no? The words are handstand, hamstring, and heavy. Okay. Handstand, hamstring, heavy. Okay. Now let's see. What do you think? Will we have the word heavy on this page? So for that, you don't need to read the whole page. Okay. All you have to do is just see the guide words. Now heavy starts with H-E-A. But both our words are H-A, H-A. So do you think heavy will be on this page? No. Okay. The first letter is same, but here H-A and H-A. For H-E, you will have to have a word with H-E on the top. Okay. The word hamstring. Let's look at the first two letters, children. The guide words have H-A and H-A. So does the word hamstring, H-A. So now to know if this word is on this page, we have to look at the third letter. The guide words have N as the third letter, H-A-P, P as the third letter, H-A-M, so M is the third letter. So do you think that this word will be on this page? No. Okay. But look at the word handstand. H-A-N-D and we have handbag. Happen means any word after handbag till happen. H-A-P means we have started with the next sequence. But H-A-N, handstand, will come before this. Okay. I hope you have understood. After this class, please open a dictionary and go through it. Why? Because all the dictionaries, I'm not sure which child has which dictionary, plus we are online sitting at homes, so I can't show you mine for all the words. Okay, so do not worry at all. If you have a little confusion, it will get over. Now let's come to the second task. The second task is pretty interesting because it's a game. Let's play. Okay, now for this activity, there's this word given which you might have seen. I'll show you again. So there's this word given. From the same word, we are going to make other new words using only the letters which are present in that word. Okay, for example, I'll show you. See, the word is beautiful. The word is beautiful. Now I have to make other meaningful words by using only these letters which you see here. B, E, A, U, T, I, F, U, L. Okay, so let's just make some. I've written some already. There can be many words, say B, E, and T. Bet, B, I, T, E, bite. Okay, B, A, I, T, bait. Every word should have a meaning. Now here I've written a few. So it is bat, fat, tail, beat, tie, and another tail, T-A-I-L, the tail of animals, and T-A-L-E, the tail stories, or yes, the stories we tell. So first word according to these will be on number one. The answers when you write, the number one will be bat, number two will be beat, number three fat, because after bat and beat I don't have any other words starting with C, D, E. Okay, but I have F, so fat, and then there are three words with T, tail, tail, and tie. So in these three letters, children, let's see the first two letters, T, A, T, I, and T, A again. The word in center has the second letter as I, whereas the other two words have A as their second letter. Now A comes before I, so we are going to check both those words. And in them, we will have to check the third letter. The first word tail has I as its third letter. And the last word tail has L as its third letter. And because I comes before L in the alphabet, our sequence will be: the word T-A-I-L will fall as fourth in alphabetical order. And next will be T-A-L-E. And the last word, of course, will be T-I-E, tie. So that is my solution. Okay, now let me tell you how to do the worksheet. This is similar to the last worksheet questions you have done, children. In this question, children, there will be four columns. The first column is words, the which words will be given, and then you see the three columns, page number, guide words, and meanings. So for each word, you will have to write page number under the page number column, guide words under the guide words column, and meanings, of course. All right. Third, that is the last question, is the fun activity which we have done just a few minutes ago. Goodbye and have a great day.